Hi, I'm Dr. Hagmeyer, and if this is the first time to my YouTube channel, I want to welcome you. And if you're just tuning in, this is the second part of a video series where I'm talking all about TSH, or thyroid stimulating hormone. In the first video on TSH, I reviewed some of the most common and overlooked symptoms associated with a high TSH. And in today's video, I'm going to be covering five common causes of a high TSH. And in the final video in this series, I'll cover the different treatment options if your TSH is high, as well as some of the pros and the cons of each thyroid treatment method. Millions of men and women around the world struggle with thyroid disease. Many of them never find answers or solutions. And the biggest reason for this epidemic of suffering has to do with what I'll be sharing with you today. The key to understanding why your loved one continues to struggle day in and day out with thyroid problems lies in the understanding of why your TSH is high in the first place. It's not about thyroid medication, but rather understanding the many causes behind this elevated TSH. And if you're like most patients with an elevated TSH, if your TSH is high, I'm going to bet that your doctor never really investigated the reasons into why this TSH is abnormally elevated. Instead, most doctors right away will write you out a prescription for either levothyroxine or Synthroid or Naturethroid or Cytomel. But my question to you is this: what is your doctor doing to address the root cause of your high TSH? Is there a reason that your TSH is elevated, or did your thyroid just decide that it was time to stop working? And I'm going to tell you that I don't believe that your thyroid just stopped working, and I don't want you to believe that either. You see, in functional medicine, it's not good enough to just dump thyroid hormones into the body when levels are low or when levels are low levels have been identified. We need to understand why the TSH is elevated in the first place. Yet dumping thyroid hormones into the body is exactly what happens in 95 to 100% of the time in the traditional medical model. It's common practice, but this does not mean that this is common practice is not what's best for you. You see, if you're taking thyroid medication and you don't need it, two things are going to happen. Number one, you're going to most likely amplify many of the existing symptoms you have. And two, it can shut down your thyroid gland to the point where it actually causes permanent damage. Now, if you have a high TSH, it's your doctor's job to figure out why the thyroid is not working and why it's not producing hormones. And if you're serious about fixing your thyroid, then at some point in time, you're going to realize that taking thyroid replacement will not fix your problem. And I want to caution you into this kind of thinking. Now, before I get into the common causes of high TSH, there's also something that I think is super important because really no one else is talking about this. And so I want you to pay very close attention here because what I'm going to tell you could very well be life-changing for you. It could be the difference between you getting sicker and sicker in the next, you know, year, 2 years or 3 years, or it could be you having a breakthrough with your health and really overcoming thyroid problems and all the different symptoms that go along with it, all right? So, number one, it's absolutely critical that you get a complete thyroid panel done, right? But if you've already had that done, that's only step one, right? Many people mistakenly think and believe that having a complete thyroid panel where markers like T3 and free T3 and total T3 and reverse T3, that will explain why they're gaining weight or why they're losing hair or why they're fatigued all the time. But complete thyroid testing is only one part of fixing the problem. Here's the thing. Blood testing will confirm that your T3 levels are low, or that your T4 levels are low, or that your reverse T3 levels are elevated. But what blood testing can't tell us is the why. Why those T3 and T4 levels are low in the first place. This is the information that we need to know in order to correct the symptoms that you have. While taking thyroid replacement may, in some cases, make a person feel better short term, the cause of the problem is going to continue. You see, the key and the most important question that needs to be unraveled here is the why in all of this. You can't effectively treat something if you don't know what the cause is. This is the reason why millions of men and women really still feel terrible despite taking thyroid replacement. And to say this another way, simply taking your hormones with thyroid replacement, whether it's Cytomel in the case of low T3 or Synthroid in the case of low T4, is not going to address the why of those low levels. And I hope that makes sense. And if it doesn't, be sure to leave a comment below. because I'll address that and explain that a little bit further. There's also one more thing that I want to talk to you about. And again, I just apologize for this taking so long to get to the meat of this video, but all of this is just so important for you to understand this. While this video is focusing on the five main causes of a high TSH, there are also reasons behind why these other thyroid markers are elevated, all right? But I won't be talking about that today, but I want you to be aware of that there are causes behind an elevated TSH, there are causes behind why T3 might be elevated or why T3 might be low. And again, I'll do other videos on this, or you can check to see if there's already videos that I've done. But for the most part, there are reasons behind each of these, right? And that's what's going to be the solution to you getting your life back and having this breakthrough in your health. All right, so let's jump into the reasons behind this high TSH. And the first one, number one, is Hashimoto's thyroiditis, right? Probably the most common cause of an elevated and high TSH level is an autoimmune mechanism known as Hashimoto's thyroiditis. In people who are diagnosed with Hashimoto's thyroiditis, their immune system attacks and it destroys small parts of the thyroid gland. And as your thyroid gland is attacked by the immune system, the end result is that the production of hormones dwindles over time. So we see less and less and less hormone being produced, right? Research shows that anywhere between 50 to 90% of all cases of hypothyroidism is actually caused by this autoimmune mechanism. The bad news is that for some of you that are watching this video and you have Hashimoto's and you don't know it because your doctor won't run a complete thyroid panel, including those antibodies that detect if your thyroid disease is caused by an autoimmune disease. Now, if your TSH is high or it's very low, let's say it's 0.04, 0.05, 0.06, 0.07, regular routine antibody testing should be done. If you have antibodies that come back, even if they're marginally elevated, let's say they're just slightly out of range or slightly, even if they're in range, but they're still elevated, I suggest you contact my office, schedule some time to talk to me. If you download my free thyroid guide and my free thyroid newsletter, you can learn so much more about the testing for Hashimoto's, identifying the autoimmune triggers behind Hashimoto's disease, as well as managing Hashimoto's disease, all right? So there's also several videos that I think will just be very, very helpful to you, for you to watch if you're newly diagnosed or if you suspect Hashimoto's as well. And the good news about this is that early detection of Hashimoto's is also important because if caught in time, there are many, many action steps that you can take to influence the course of this disease and reduce the destruction and the damage caused by the immune system. But you need to take action sooner than later, and you need to realize that taking thyroid replacement is not going to stop this autoimmune disease. It's only going to replace low hormones. And I always tell my patients that it's not difficult to diagnose Hashimoto's disease. What's difficult and what's tricky is identifying what the individual triggers are in each person that has autoimmune disease. And then it's up to that patient to make the various and necessary lifestyle changes required to support the immune system. And this goes way beyond just an autoimmune paleo diet and taking some supplements, okay? So let's move on to another reason behind a high or elevated TSH, and this is reason number two. Number two is elevated cortisol levels. Another important cause of high TSH is due to either acute or prolonged stress. You see, cortisol is considered a primary stress hormone, but high levels stem from things that where we have disrupted sleep habits or sleep patterns, hidden infections, emotional stress. Maybe we have childhood trauma. Maybe we've been exposed to heavy metals. Maybe environmental toxins are playing a role. Maybe we have gut inflammation and we have maybe fluctuating blood sugar levels as well as food intolerances or food allergies. These are all stressors on your body, and collectively, they can influence your thyroid levels as well as your immune system. Here's a study I came across published in Thyroid Research 2012 titled "Elevated Thyroid Stimulating Hormone is Associated with Elevated Cortisol in Healthy Young Men and Women." Now let's dig into another common cause of elevated TSH. Reason number three is excess iodine, right? While many functional medicine doctors talk about iodine deficiency causing hypothyroidism, I want you to be aware that excess iodine is equally problematic. And while it's true that iodine is needed to make thyroid hormones, iodine excess results in hypothyroidism. This excess iodine can come from CT scans, it can come from MRIs, it can come from other diagnostic or contrast imaging. Another surprising area where you can be exposed to excess amounts of iodine can be from your supplements. It might be your multivitamin. It could be your multimineral. Sometimes even the supplements that people are taking to support their thyroid gland, like the ones that you see here, can cause or be a culprit in raising these levels, right? So again, there are also foods that are high in iodine, such as things like kelp and milk and cheese, right? We also know that foods high in sodium usually also contain high amounts of iodine. And of course, it can come from iodized salt. The other thing I want you to know about excess iodine, regardless of where it's coming from, it's been shown to flare up Hashimoto's disease, right? Which is, again, that number one cause on our list of why you have an elevated TSH. So now, if you're going to check iodine levels, right? And again, I want you to realize that it's not a very reliable method of testing your iodine levels in blood, right? Iodine levels cannot be measured reliably because blood, of course, is just, there's too much variation in your iodine levels through blood. So what you'll need to do is you'll need to speak with your doctor and you'll need to get a jug. And you can contact any local lab, Quest or LabCorp, and you want to get a jug. And what you want to do is you want to collect your urine for the over the period of 24 hours. And what I do and what I suggest from time to time with my patients is, again, testing these urinary iodine concentrations. So if you're an adult and your urinary iodine levels are greater than 300 micrograms, that's considered excess iodine intake. Now, if you're pregnant, levels over 500 micrograms is considered excess iodine. So my word of caution here is really is that anyone who has thyroid problems or even symptoms of thyroid disease, think twice about eating foods that are high in salt or taking supplements that contain iodine. So again, just a quick recap here. So far, I've covered three of the five causes of high TSH, right? We talked about Hashimoto's autoimmune thyroid disease. That was number one. Number two, we talked about high cortisol levels and being locked in this stress response, this fight or flight response. That can cause high TSH levels. That was number two. And I also talked about excess iodine. That's number three, okay? Now, reason number four that your TSH is elevated is medications, right? This one can be a little bit tricky because it's easy to get hung up on the TSH levels, but anytime a level where the TSH levels are high, we need to again ask why could it be high, right? If you remember what I said in the first video where I was explaining how high TSH levels is really the body's response to low levels of circulating T3 and T4 hormones, right? We said that when T3, T4 levels drop in the blood, the brain senses those low levels and the brain releases TSH, right, from the pituitary gland, thyroid stimulating hormone. And then that acts on the thyroid gland to make more thyroid hormones, right? So again, we need to think about the possibility that certain medications that we might be taking, even if sometimes they're vitamins, that these things can elevate and interfere with that. Again, lower T3 and lower T4 levels. I'm going to do a whole video on this in terms of as it relates to medications. Now, the other thing here is realize that many different medications affect the thyroid level in many different ways. And depending on the type of medication that you're taking, that can determine how it will affect your thyroid gland. Not all medications affect the thyroid gland the same way. Some medications can affect and reduce the amount of T4 levels and T3 levels. Some can affect the way the thyroid gland actually makes these thyroid hormones. Other medications can interfere with the way T3 and T4 hormones are released from the gland itself out into the bloodstream. And then there are other medications that actually cause inflammation in the thyroid gland itself, which of course, you know, I've done videos on that can be a problem. And then of course, some medications can affect the way thyroid hormones bind to the cells, where they bind to proteins like thyroid binding globulin. And then other medications can affect liver and gut function, impacting the way T4 is converted into T3. So what you see here is you see many, many different ways that medications can influence the thyroid gland, okay? Now, because I have a video coming out on this very specific topic, what I will say is that medications and thyroid levels in general can be affected by things like heart arrhythmias. So if you're taking medication for heart arrhythmia, if you're taking medication such as antidepressants, if you're taking medications that treat, let's say, viral hepatitis, if you're taking medications, let's say, birth control pills, if you're taking medications for attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, right? If you're taking medications for restless leg syndrome or drugs that affect the dopamine levels in your body, such as those medications that are geared towards Parkinson's disease. All of these medications can affect the thyroid gland in one or more ways. All right, I just spoke about this in something that I was talking about with another doctor here, where they were prescribing medications, and I shared with the patient that the medications that they were on were interfering with their thyroid hormones. So again, if this is something that you're noticing, this is a conversation you need to have with your endocrinologist or your prescribing doctor, right? So hopefully, what you see from today is that there are many, many different root causes of why that TSH could be elevated, right? It's much more complicated than simply taking thyroid hormone levels to raise your levels. If you suspect a medication, again, is contributing to this high TSH and your low thyroid function, again, I encourage you to do two things. Number one, watch some of the videos that I've done that talk specifically about the medications and even some of the vitamins for that matter that can skew your test results, right? Like biotin, for example. I'll get into that in another video. So again, if you're taking those things, be aware of that. Have that conversation with your doctor. And number two, again, I encourage you to have a serious conversation with your endocrinologist or the prescribing doctor regarding these drug effects on your thyroid levels. Now, the last thing that I want to discuss with you today as it relates to, again, the five common causes of a high TSH, and this one is going to be related to thyroid nodules, right? Unfortunately, when it comes to thyroid nodules, there are several different types of nodules. Some can be hot, some can be cold, some can cause elevations in TSH, and actually some can actually lower your TSH levels. What we do know, however, is that thyroid nodules are common and frequently discovered in clinical practice, and because some nodules or cysts can affect thyroid function, I recommend that anyone who routinely has a high TSH and low T4 levels, I recommend they get an ultrasound. Now, an ultrasound is the best diagnostic study to evaluate thyroid problems in the neck. And of course, if one suspects a nodule, if you are having any kind of problem with swallowing or difficulty breathing, or you notice that your voice gets hoarse, again, watch the video that I did titled Thyroid Nodules, right? There are a few different videos that I have out there. I think one is called the Real Cause of Thyroid Nodules and Goiters. The other one is, I think, titled When You Need to Be Concerned About Thyroid Nodules. You can see those on my YouTube channel. But again, I definitely encourage you to, again, if you're experiencing those symptoms, get an ultrasound. Make sure that these are not cancerous. There are many, many different causes of these nodules. Again, and there's a reason why I put those videos out there for you to watch. Please watch them, become educated, because again, you're the only one who's going to be able to take care of yourself the way you need to be taken care of, all right? As always, I hope you enjoyed today's video and the information that I shared with you. Don't forget to comment below. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. If you have questions about working with me, one of my nutritionists in practice, whether you need help implementing a certain diet or you're looking to dig deeper into the root cause of some of these health problems that you're struggling with, visit my website. Look for the Start Here button in the left-hand corner and tell me a little bit about the kinds of problems that you're struggling with and where we can be most helpful to you, all right? We'll send you out an email within just a few minutes with some recommendations in terms of where we suggest that you start. And again, we can further discuss your case. We can talk together about what the best approach would be. And again, I hope you enjoyed this video and we'll talk to you soon. Take care.